Paladin Hardwin's whistle-like device sits nestled in your hand. The wizened old turtle peers up at you inquisitively as she makes her slow, slow path across the beach.
Smells good, eh? Smells so good. Can't... Silly. Silly. I mean the rich, warm, red smell of raw meat. Quartermistress Anna, saint of a woman, sometimes throws me some for dinner. Now I smell so much in that building over there. I can hear it too, covered with flies. My favorite adds a bit of crunch.
The turtle nods her head sagely and tremulously turns to resume her dignified procession towards dinner.
I make this simpler. You tell me where Hanag is, and I call off your family's execution.
The Magister Quartermistress works at her station, kneading dough with her strong, floured hands. Seeing a potential customer, she brightens.
it's good to bake again. With the war, I haven't made a pie in, oh, must be 5 years now. But Magister Raymond's visiting, and that man just loves a good apple pie. Tchah! I doubt it could be better than my dear departed Mama's recipe. Tell me this, what's the most important bit?
Her eyes light up, and she licks her lips with delight.
Ooh, you know how to make a girl hungry, so you do. I tell you, it'll be full bellies and happy faces tonight if I can get this one made. And our troops need all the home comforts they can get out here. Well, I use it to keep the milk and cheese cold. But there's some high-priority digging for Dallas going on a lot deeper than I ever go. All I know is that it's well above my pay grade, and there's less and less folks showing up for dinner in the evenings. Happy to. Good day to you. And stay clear of the cave. It's for magisters only.
Thank you. Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Keep distant. My own demons haunt me too closely. I cannot also bear the burden of yours.
Having extra help in a fight, I'll guarantee you that.
Buying or selling?
Capital.
Good luck to you.
Together, Bree. I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Have you anything that will protect against bone white?
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tun, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget.
Right track. That tablet Riker wants has to be close.
Careful now. That's
be
a trap.
Be warned. Beyond lies death. The Divine Order guarantees it. Heed the word of the White Magisters. Turn ye around.
This corpse is wearing black ring garb. How strange. Careful. I've spotted a trap.
The first thing you notice is the figure's empty eyeless sockets. The second thing is that your skin is crawling. The third is that your senses feel heightened. The fourth is that he is, or was, Black Ring. As your hand nears the ghost, your skin begins to itch. But more than that, your world expands, your vision narrows and fades, and your perception of the cavern is enhanced. Your nerves hum as if stretched taut. And you realize this is, or was, the ghost's reality. He was a guide. His job, to know the way. You see him, on pain of purging, guide magisters into the cavern depths, there to continue their secret dig. You see him float above the traps, or vanish in one place and reappear in the next. And then, at last, you see him murdered in cold blood as the magisters left the cave. Their work here finished. His services no longer required. His wages paid with his own soul, which he was allowed to keep. You feel his anger and his confusion and his raw and naked pain, and you hear the cavern echo with his cries. He turns to you at last, those eyeless sockets staring into you, and as your senses crawl beneath your skin, you realize you know the truth already. You can do as he did. You can find your way over and around the accursed surfaces, those deadly stains that rise from the gods know what, deep underground. You have the power. You have what it takes.
Divine order, with Black Ring slaves, Lucian would be thrilled.
Maybe if I make this simpler, you tell me where Hanag is, and I call off your family's execution.
No. Okay, I'll tell you. She's gone to Arx for Lucian's day.
Oh dear. When you lie like that, you really break my sense of immersion.
Paladin Hardwin's whistle-like device sits nestled in your hand. You hear the sound of fluttering wings, but no bird appears. The sound dies away.
Come on, sorcerer. It's always the same tale. You're boring me.
I've said...
Paladin Hardwin's... You hear the sound of fluttering...
Oh, I've heard all this before. You really need to work on your storytelling skills.
White Magister Jonathan's got that sorcerer on the ropes up there. Would be better if it were that Hanag woman, but I'm not complaining. Well, not too much, anyway.
Paladin Hardwin's whistle-like device sits... You hear the sound of fluttering wings.
And I call off your family's execution.
No. Okay, I'll tell you.
The Magister squints at you, at length.
Careful you don't get in the way up there, frog's legs. Jonathan's blade is ready. And I doubt he'll be caring much who or what he slices.
Paladin Hardwin's... You hear the sound of fluttering... Paladin Hardwin's, you hear the sound of...
Come on, sorcerer. It's always the same tale. You're boring me.
I've said all I know. Please.
Ho-hum. I've heard all this before. You really need to work on your storytelling skills.
Paladin Hardwin's whistle. You hear the sound of flutter.
Don't toy with me, sorcerer. You know where your mistress is, and I know you know it, so talk.
I don't know where Hanag's gone. I tell you if I did, I swear on my father's grave.
Oh, he swears. Did you hear that, everyone? He swears. Why, that's almost as good as a pinky promise.
The White Magister swiftly pivots toward you and draws his blade. You recognize his face at once. He's Gareth's friend, Jonathan.
Did you come for the show, lizard? Good timing. The interrogation scene is over, so we're almost at the climax.
He chuckles and pokes the inside of his cheek with his tongue.
The hammer herself sent you, did she? Well, you'll just have to report back to her with the truth. Why, this here sorcerer died in a void-woken attack. Alas, there was nothing we could do.
The sorcerer fidgets, and you notice a thin dagger resting in his palm. He slices away a bit of rope, then looks at you, eyebrows raised.
Why on the god's green ground would I make things harder than I need to? I've got the problem hanging over there.
He wiggles his unsheathed blade as if it were a child's toy.
And I'm holding a quick and easy solution.
The hanging sorcerer winks at you and cuts another segment of rope. He'll soon be free.
Well, she...
His eyes narrow.
What are you playing at?
The White Magister spins on his heels, just as the hanging sorcerer breaks free of his bond.
A plot twist. I love it. Keeps things interesting.
Damn you. Damn all of you.
Thank you.
finally.
Well, take you.
meet your maker.